I have stated from the beginning to be the truth as it has been the truth.
I want people to understand what the truth is.
I am confident the American people will come to realize I have not violated the trust.
I am confident by the end of this campaign, people will know they can trust me.
The entire story is there.
I turned over everything I was obligated to turn over.
I want the facts out.
I want those emails out.
I'm sorry, I just hope I haven't let you down.
I'm sorry about that. I take responsibility.
All right, you see the strategy there to draw a comparison between Hillary Clinton now and President Nixon back then. With me now, Ian Pryor with American Crossroads, the group behind that ad. Ian, good to have you this morning.
Hi, Victor. How are you?
I'm doing well, and it's good to have you because I want to ask you first. I went all over the website, did some reading, and I know American Crossroads is backed by Karl Rove, helped to found it. He's been very critical of Donald Trump. Is this group pro-Trump or just anti-Clinton?
Well, for the past year, we have been conducting research through polling, through focus groups on how best to define Hillary Clinton. So I would say that, you know, over the course of a year, we have become the anti-Hillary Clinton super PAC. We also are highly focused on maintaining the Senate in Republican hands, so we are a dual operation in that respect.
So one more time, and maybe I can just narrow it down. Does American Crossroads want Donald Trump to be the next president of the United States? Is it a pro-Trump group?
Well, I would say that we do not want Hillary Clinton to be president of the United States, and I think that ad makes it clear.
So it's anybody but Clinton, and Trump happens to be the anybody?
Exactly.
Okay. All right. Got that clear. Now let me go to what we heard from Bill Fletcher. He said during the story that it's not his job to sell Hillary Clinton. That's for other people. This is an anti-Clinton group, as you've just defined. I wonder, in tying the Republicans to Trump, can this group tie Democrats to Hillary Clinton? Is that effective down ballot for Republicans?
Oh, absolutely, and that should be the strategy throughout the country, especially in these competitive Senate races. Look, we've done research. We've found several things with Hillary Clinton. She's not trusted. She's seen as somebody that views herself as above the rules. And people are looking for any reason not to vote for her. There are also people that may vote for her but do not want to give her a blank check. Because she has been a walking, talking scandal for over 40 years, there may be swing voters that say, look, I'll vote for Hillary Clinton, but I do not want the Senate falling into Democratic hands because I do not want to give her the full power of government like Obama had from 2008 to 2010.
Donald Trump has said many times that he's going after, and his campaign has said they're going after the Bernie Sanders supporters, part of the Bernie or bust movement. How do Republicans get those voters to support Donald Trump, or in your case, not vote for Hillary Clinton?
Well, I think it's more of showing why they voted against Hillary Clinton throughout the primary season. I mean, look, nobody thought that Bernie Sanders was going to take Hillary Clinton to the wire a year ago. Most people haven't even heard of Bernie Sanders outside of Vermont and Washington, but he created a movement that was based partly on his charisma, you know, a 75-year-old socialist speaking on new issues to young voters, but partly on the fact that Hillary Clinton is viewed as the establishment Washington, D.C. politician who, again, has 40 years of being in the spotlight in not such a good way, and those people are not necessarily going to come out and vote for Hillary Clinton simply because she has a D next to her name. So it's important to continue to define Hillary Clinton, to continue to remind people of her long history of scandals, and to continue to show that, hey, these scandals are not just an isolated incident. This is something that has happened for decades, and as we just saw this morning on this show, we now have this Clinton Foundation issue with a donor that is put on an important intelligence position.
But there is
this
one
is not
element,
something that's going to end.
There is one element that the polls show unites Democrats, whether they support Bernie Sanders, they support Hillary Clinton, or neither. That is, in large part, wanting to keep Donald Trump out of the White House. Now, you've said that this is not a pro-Trump group. How does Donald Trump, if he does, complicate that effort?
Well, you know, I think one of the things that Trump needs to do is he needs to focus his attacks on Hillary Clinton and her surrogates on the substance, on her past abuses of government power, on where her policies are going to lead America, on how she is not in touch with the average American. I think when he engages in the attacks that he's been engaging in, that has the effect of hurting some of these Bernie Sanders supporters, or hurting his cause with some of these Bernie Sanders supporters that don't want to support Clinton.
If he brings back some of those attacks, those lines at his event in about 2.5 hours now. Ian Pryor with American Crossroads, thanks so much for being with us this morning.
Thanks a lot.
Sure.